Swagatam Sarvebhyaha. Adhuna, now I request Dr. Ramasubramaniam sir, Professor of Physics Department, IIT Bombay, to be the chairperson of this session. And I also invite Mr. Venketeswara Pai and Dr. Mahesh for this current session.
Friends, Dr. Venketeswara Pai so had his master's in Kerala in physics, and then he got inspired to work on Indian astronomy and mathematics. So he completed his PhD at IIT Bombay. Then he worked for a couple of years in Shastra University, Tanjavur. So currently he is in ICER Pune. So there he offers courses so on Indian astronomy mathematics. So Dr. Pai, so please proceed. So he has been recently working on particularly the Kerala works. So Drukkarana is one of the works which Professor Srinivas was mentioning in the morning to be studied in detail. So Pai has taken up that work. So he'll be making his presentation on Drukkarana. Dr. Pai.
Thank you, Professor Ramasubramanian. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers of KVSRF, Professor Sriram. Once again, I would like to acknowledge, because this work is in collaboration with Professor Sriram. The title of the talk is An Overview of Drukkarana. Druk is, of course, related to the observation, and Karana is a class of one of the classes of astronomical literature. So based on the computational aspects and the parameters, we can divide the class of literature into, broadly divide into two. There is one is Siddhantas, the other is Karanas. However, Drukkarana is a special text in the sense that it is quite different from Karana texts such as Khandaka, Khadeka. Usual Karana texts give the simplest computational procedures for the computation of astronomical quantities and do not mention the parameters such as revolution numbers of the planets in a Mahayuga, as in the case of Siddhantic texts. However, this Drukkarana mentions these parameters, as well as they deal, the text Drukkarana deals with different spherical astronomical problems that is not present in usual Karana texts. So in short, the purpose served by Drukkarana may be stated as it is from the Drukkarana itself. Druktulyam Karanam, the Karana text which yields the results in accordance with the observation. Now the author declares right at the beginning of the text, there's chapter 1, second half of the verse 1, that he is going to tell the Karana equal to the observer for making the Balas to understand, the two is missing here, to understand the mathematical methods. Here Balas, as pointed out by Professor Mishra, is Grahana Dharana Patuhu Balaha. So which means the one who is capable of observing and retaining the information. He also emphasizes that he is going to explain this in the popular language, which is he calls as Bhasha. The language used for the composition is Manipravalam, which is a mixture of Sanskrit and Malayalam. So now, what is the time of composition of Drukkarana? There are three instances in the text from where we can infer the date of composition of the text. At first, in the verse 28-29 of chapter 1, it is mentioned that the observations have been made by the mathematicians for 30 years on the Arabian Sea from Kalyabda 4678 to 4708. That corresponds to 1576 AD and 1606 AD. So the
Arabian.
I'll come to that.
Paschimambodhi.
So the modern name for that Paschimambodhi is,
modern
Indian name, yeah. So the verse goes like this: Jasustaveti kalyabde tudarnar avanitale paschimambodhi tiratta ninna 30 varshavam. Jasustaveti is 4678, kalyabde kalyabda nokki idu ganakanmarum janasevanu vatsare. So janaseva corresponds to 4708, okay. So for 30 years then the observation, and so we can conclude that the text has Maitha composed after 1606, and in the there are 10 chapters in the text, and there is a last appendix which is known as Upasamhara, where the concluding verse of this chapter, that is Upasamhara, it is mentioned that the text has composed or finished the composition in the Kollam year 783, which corresponds to AD 1608. Kollabde Bahisono, this is the we have edited, but the manuscript gives the reading as Kollambe Bahisono. This K.V. Sharma, in his article article on Yukti Bhasha, gives the number this Kollambe Bahisono, he interpret it as the Kali days elapsed. However, decode using Katapayadi, we only going to get 78339, so there is an error in that. So one is added. So there is no 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 digits. Here there are only 6 syllables. So he cites the wish paper for the same. However, when we decode the string, it turns out to be erroneous, and the actual value encoded is 78331. And at the same time, wish does take it as column year 783, not the Kali days, and not the Kali days. And third evidence that we have is in the last chapter, that is 10th chapter, where he is explaining the Vakya method for finding the moon's longitude. He gives Putram Dhatvanu Saukhyonu as the Khanda. Khanda is the day when moon's anomaly becomes zero close to the sunrise. And that corresponds to 1706821. And as K.V. Sharma has done in the case of Vakyakarana to find the time of composition of Vakyakarana, and also in Karana Paddhati by us. If we add the anomalistic cycle of the moon, it comes out to be January 20, 1606, 1719, 193. So the composition of the text is around 1606 to 1608, and probably the composition might have started in the 1606, and he finished the composition during 1608. So that's quite clear. Now the question is authorship. So the So this is 12372. So this is the Khanda. So if you add 12, 3, 6, these are the anomalistic cycles given in the text. These are different from the Karana Paddhati. So if we add this 43178, that is Hamsa Pallava. These are nothing but the linear combination of 12372 and 3031. Now, the author's name is not mentioned in the text, but was ascribed to Jyesthadeva by Charles Wish. K.V. Sharma was also of this opinion. As for K.V. Sharma, the time of Jyesthadeva is in between 1500 to 1610 AD, based on the following evidence, which is found in an old manuscript of a Malayalam commentary on Surya Siddhanta, preserved in the Oriental Institute, Baroda. Manuscript number is this. So it goes like this. Parameshwaran Vatasheri Nambudiri Nilayaha सौम्यातीरस्था परमेश्वरः अस्य तनयो दामोदरः अस्य शिष्यो नीलकंठ सोमयाजी इद्देहं तंत्रसंग्रहं आर्यभटीय भाष्यं मुदलाय ग्रंथंगल्क कर्तावागुन्नु लक्ष्मीर् निहितध्यानैः लक्ष्म्या लक्ष्मीश निहितध्यानैः इति अस्य कलिदिन कालनिर्णयः पूर्वोक्तदामोदरस्य शिष्यः ज्येष्ठदेवः इद्देहं परङ्गोट्टु नम्बूदिरियागुन्नु युक्तिभाषा ग्रन्थत्तिन्दे ग्रन्थत्ते उण्डाक्कियतुम् इद्देहं तन्ने ज्येष्ठदेवन्दे शिष्यन् त्रिकण्ठीर्यो अच्युतपिशारड्, एंड इट गोस् अप् टु दि भट्टदिरि नारायण. हियर् इट इस् वेरि क्लियर्ली दिस् पासेज् मेन्शन्स् अबौट् दि the work the Yukti Bhasha has been composed by Jyesthadeva. And if we draw a tree, the Parameshwara is 1360, 1455, then Sant Damodara, pupils Nilakanta Swamiyaji and Jyesthadeva we can fix. This is how the, this is based on the K.V. Sharma, K.V. Sharma's, that paper. So the time period of Jyesthadeva is 1500 to 1610. Now this is the only basis for ascribing the authorship to Jyesthadeva, because the text is composed between, it is during 1606 to 1608, and Jyesthadeva is the person who is during that period, was there during that period.
Mm-hmm. Assuming that when Nilakanta was in his teens, Damodara would have been, I don't know, at least 30, you know? So he must have been over 80, 90 years old when he taught Jyesthadeva.
Anyway, so this has been put because of,
these are not definitive dates. So there will be some range, because most of people will be centenarians.
Yeah, so this is
1543 is known of Nilakanta.
No, so this chart has been put just because this is given by K.V. Sharma in his paper. I have just transformed into a tree. So the basis for ascribing the authorship to Jyesthadeva is based on this. Only this is the there is no evidence, there is no explicit evidence for that. Only this is the evidence, but there might be another person, there is no explicit evidence, so there might be any other person who might have been living during this period. We don't know. No, this is just, but we think that it may not be Jyesthadeva because of several reasons. It's not that there is no compelling evidence, or we are just confused whether it is authored by Jyesthadeva or not. At this point, yeah. We have to resolve the confusion. Now, contents of Drikkarana in brief. The text contains 10 chapters with 416 and a half verses. The first chapter has 32 verses, revision of parameters based on the observation. Then 29 verses, corrections associated with the computation of the main planet. Then Manda and Shigra, corrections to the planet and computations pertaining to them. Computations of arcsine, longitude and right ascension of a planet, shadow. Then fifth chapter, computations pertaining to moon shadow. Corrected moon shadow at any given instance, second correction to the moon, lunar and solar eclipses, zenith distance. These are spherical astronomical problems which are not found in usual Karana texts. Vyatipata and Vaidvata, angular separation between planet and the sun, elevation of the lunar horns, modified continuous diffraction method for finding the successive approximations to the rate of motion of the planets, precession, planetary orbits, true distance of the sun and the moon from the earth and their orbits, vakyas for the sun and the moon. Now, so we'll give some highlights. Just one is Yogyadi Vakya, just simply telling that using Yogyadi Vakyas you can obtain the true sun. But from last one, vakyas are not given. And there is some 6 to 7 verses for moon's longitude. Just similar to Vakyakarana method, but the anomalistic cycles are different from Vakyakarana. Now from chapter 1, after Mangalacharana, there are some couple of verses where he gives the evolution of parameters, where somewhat he gives the chronology of the somewhat history of astronomers. We can say Kalyabdam Trisahasratil Paranjanala Nalila Ottuvanidu Marilla Grahanadi Galumme Karanangalumuttida Siddhantangalumuttida Tada Yarabato Nama Ganakastadvat Bhuvi Jnanatungeti Kalyabde Jatana Yavanitale Girutungeti Kalyabde Ganitam Nirmitam Param Shastram Aryabatiyakhyam Tasmin Pariyaya Muktavan. This is Manipravalam actually, yeah. So it's rich in Sanskrit, yeah. So rich, yeah. No, but it's language itself is actually rich Sanskrit, mainly Sanskrit. Sanskritized Malayalam, you can say, yeah. Sanskritized Malayalam, yeah. Some 80% of the words and yeah.
Malayalam is
Sanskrit people will say in Malayalam, in Malayalam people will say this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. No, 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 80%. Yeah. No, in this, in this, 80% may be Sanskrit, that's why. It has been stated in the above verses that in Kalyabda 3000, the computational results for eclipses, etc., obtained by both Siddhantas and Karanas were not matching with the observed ones. Then there was one mathematician named Aryabhata, born on the earth in the Kalyabda 3600, who composed a mathematical treatise which came to be known by the name Aryabhatiya, which contained updated revolution numbers of the planets. Then the verse continues. Itinischitya palaram acharichchavaniyatale chirakalam galinjappol neekam valare vannidu rangashobhanu kalyabdhe kaschit vipravarastada paschimabhodhi teeratu ninnu nokkittu vachathu dvadashabdham galinjattu tantrasangraham enna tasmin pariyayam pinne stholamayittu solliyal. So he mentions tantrasangraha here. Jasustaveti kalyabdhe tudarna ravaniyatale paschimabhodhi teeratu ninnu 30 varshavum. So he has observed, observation has been made for 30 years. Yeah, Nokedu Ganakanmarum, Janasevanu Atsare, Sukshmam Varati Nirmichal, Ganita Agamam in our Inium Kandukolanam, Chirakala, were another. Yeah. So it also hence definitely.
That last sentence you have to state it and explain it.
Yeah, so Inium Kandukolanam, Chirakala, were another. So the based on these observations, the parameters were corrected and the system came to be known as Ganita Agama and. One has to repeat the observation and modify the parameters. That's the essence of. Not been translated. That's what. So, one has to observation has to be continued. Observations have to be continued, and the parameters have to be modified accordingly.
Chirakala.
All the times. Yeah. All the times. Yeah, sure. Thank you. Yeah, so other topics in chapter 1. So computation of Ahargana, then mean longitude and correction to it. And there are Kalivatsaras corresponding to different planets when the computer and observed values are values coincide. These years have been given. And also he tells that there is a shift in the case of Mercury. For that, he has given he has revised the parameter and given the revolution number for the Mercury. Now in chapter 2 again, he lists the revised revolution numbers. Again, these are in Katapayadi. So these are the revolution made by the planets in the Mahayuga as per Drikkarana. Jnananam Namrago Bhanuhu. So we have Namrago. So we have also compared these values with the Aryabhatiya, Tantra Sangraha and Karana Paddhati corrected revolutions based on the Parahita Sakabda correction.
So much does it depend on Mercury?
So Mercury, it's more closer to, I think, Tantra Sangraha, yeah.
Okay.
Now, other topics in chapter 2, Kalyadi Dhruva Samskara. Deshantra Samskara, finding the main planets at mean sunrise at one's own place, Aharmana Samskara. Then, chapter 3, first he gives the mandochas of the planets, Arkadinam, Vichandrana, Mandochangal Paranyadam. Except, Vichandrana means except moon. Iliyadadayattu Rashantam Vangu Madhyame, Sovandhya Jayashri, Balidanavena, Sarvasya Nathaha, Sarvasya Nathena Munindra Ramaha, this is how he tabulates the value for Mandochas and Aryabhatiya value and Tantra Sangraha values are.
It should be only text where Mandocha values are given with minutes. Of the text we have seen.
Have
you seen any other text where
I think Karanottama, I'm not sure. Karanottama. Karanottama only the text we have. Because the finding the mandajyas and epicycle radius for mandas and shigras, the method is similar to Karanottama.
Karanottama
Achyuta Pisharani. So then the mandala diameter of the planets, so he gives a procedure, an algorithm for finding the mandala epicycle diameter. So mandavyasangal cholidam arkadinam pramadiha sita chakro labhapujyo yajamano nasaukhyakrat dharma punyasunathoyam nalajo vyasa samjinam. So these are the mandala diameters, and then one has to do a samskara for this kuda, for Mars, etc. Kujadigalka samskaram vyasatil chedu kollanam. So and the correction goes like this. D dasham is the these diameters which he has defined. One has to correct it with delta dm. Delta dm is 10 into r sin m by h. Naya is 10. Gna is multiplication. Dorjya is r sin m. Rajangai nandanehi. Rajanga nandana are the divisors corresponding to Mars, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus, and Saturn. So if you do so, this becomes the sputavyasas. If we add delta dm or subtract, then to dm we get d dash m. Then we have to find mandadopala from d dash m by multiplying 100 into r sin m divided by d dash m, where r sin m is the mandakendra. And from this one can obtain the circumference, and the inferred value for the manda dimensions of planets manda epicycles are these. These are the inferred value from those equations. So this is at the beginning of the odd quadrant, and this is at the beginning of the even quadrant.
Those are decimal.
Which one?
Decimal part of degrees.
Decimal part of degrees. Yeah. These are inferred values, not given by computed values. So again, compared with Aryabhatiya and Tantrasangha. Similarly, there is a procedure for finding Shigraha epicycles too. So I'm not going to explain the procedure. So and the tabulated values, inferred values obtained from the computation are for Dhrikarna is this, and Aryabhatiya and also compared with Aryabhatiya and Tantrasangha. Yeah. So this is Aryabhatiya, Aryabhatiya values are Mercury is same. Yeah. Oh, you mean the ordinate even quadrant. Yeah. Now comes to the true longitudes of the planets. So this is how Kujavagishamandanam Shigrocham Bhanu Madhyamam Budhanum Shukranum Pinne Bhanu Madhyamam Samadhyam. Now I state the procedure for correcting the longitudes for Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. Shigrocha is the mean sun. For Mercury and Venus, the mean sun itself is the mean planet. Avark Shigramayidum Tangal Kundaya. So this is actually Tangal Kundaya. So there is a typographical mistake here. Tangal Kundaya Madhyamam. Moon Vachuttu Nadwe Vachirinadil Ninniha. So for them, their mean would become the Shigra. Having placed this at three places, the Swamandocha has to be subtracted from the one which is placed in the middle, and the Mandajya is to be found. Mandajya kondun ardhichya vama bhagatta samskaricha tadum punaha. Then make it into half. Then again it has to, the correction has to be applied to that. Then again that has to be placed at two different places and subtract Shigrocha from them based on the longitude, whether it is Mrigadi or Karkyadi. Then again you have to divide it by two, then again subtract the Mandocha from that and obtain Mandajya. Then the entire result, the full Manda correction has to be made at the quantity which is placed at the right hand side. Okay, so the details are given here. Let theta m is the madhyama, then apply half manda correction to theta m. That is theta 1 equals theta m plus half x, half into manda correction. Find theta 2, that is theta 1 plus half into shigra correction. Obtain manda sputa from theta 2, that is theta 3 equals theta m plus full manda correction. Then find theta 4, that is theta 3 plus full shigra correction. Okay, and at the end, he says that Samskarichittu kaanumbol pujadinam sutam varum. If you do so, you will get the true longitudes for Mars, etc. Mumbile tilla shukranum budanum moonu porume. In the case of Shukra and Venus and Mercury, only three corrections are required, sufficient, yeah. Three corrections are sufficient. We had, minus, yeah. No, it's Manda correction and Shigra correction. It's hyphen actually, yeah. So we had a confusion which three are to be chosen. So this is because one cannot avoid full Manda and full Shigra corrections in the process. In that case, if it is just the traditional planetary model which was prevalent before the revised model of Nilakantha Swamiyaji. So it's not the revised planetary model. So that is how we thought that it may not be Jyesthadeva, because Jyesthadeva is very clear in explain in Yukti Bhasha, he uses revised planetary model. But Professor Sriram was telling that maybe he was, Yukti Bhasha is a commentary of Tantra Sangraha. So it is just pointing out that, it's the view of Nilakantha Swamiyaji, but he may not be accepting that particular model. So he may be accepting this model.
It could be earlier composition.
Which one? Tantra, no. Tantra Sangraha is definitely, Yukti Bhasha. But this Karanottama, clearly, there is no ambiguity in Karanottama planetary model. So it's very clearly, it is a revised planetary model. There is understanding also, there is no ambiguity. Here, it is ambiguous that which, 5 minutes, which is to be chosen. Yeah, so and chapter 3, these are the other topics in chapter 3. Chapter 4 about palangulas, and while giving palangulas, he lists the he gives the list of palangulas pertaining to different places in Kerala: Siyanandapura, Kollam, Tiruvalla, Kodungallur, Mahavana, Shivapperur, Alattur, Kukkudakroda, Kollamnur. 12 and 5. So Perinjallur. Mahavana, the near Thrissur, yeah, south of Thrissur.
So it's going from south to north.
Yeah, but here only Kollam north he is telling, yeah. So maybe there is a Kollam in northern, which is, north Kollam. North there is a place Kollam in after Kolikod, north of Calicut, near Kannur, yeah. Between Kannur and Calicut. Perinjallur is again further north. No, Perinjallur is not common. Kollam is common. Kollam is common. Kukkudakroda is just, we feel that is just the Sanskrit translation of Kozhikode. Yeah. So.
Alattur is the Parameshwara's place.
Yes, yeah. So here this Kukkudakroda, when Kodik, the name Kozhikode has, we don't know. It's just, we feel that it's just. Kukkudakroda. Kukkuda is,
Kukkuda is
usually the Pura, like Pura, in Malayalam you have, use Koda, like Pura. It's not a Sanskrit word, of course. It's not a Sanskrit word. Yeah, Kasar Koda. So this is, this is not a Sanskrit word. So it's a Dravidian word only, but it's just translated into Sanskrit. So there is a suspicion about this, some suspicion. So chapter 4 again, obtaining true sun from shadow, instantaneous true sun and the precisional motion. Here he gives the method as given in Surya Siddhanta, as well as general procedure for precisional motion, charprana kalantara correction, obtaining kalagna and madhyana kalagna, padachaya, then obtaining domon from the hypotenuse, obtaining time elapsed after sunrise from Shanku at that instant,
So all these spherical astronomical problems. So this briefly about moon shadow. Chapter 5 is about moon shadow.
Now what is moon shadow?
Chandra Chaya.
Same.
Nilakanta, there is a similarity. So you don't know the details, but yeah.
February 18.
The starting of Kali Yuga in as per Gregorian calendar. So this is the longest chapter in Rikarna, having 68 verses about solar and lunar eclipses. So different ways of computing solar and lunar eclipses. And chapter 7 is about, there are obtaining R cosine of declination of the sun and the moon, while explaining the different methods for obtaining the Vetipata, R cosine of the latitude of the sum of disks of the sun and the moon, again spherical astronomical problems. So conjunction of the planets, and there are two subsections in this chapter 8. One is conjunction of planets and the other is Shringonnati. So there is an editorial division that is made by Professor Sharma, or we don't know, maybe in the manuscript, or so there is a subsection in this chapter. There is a second correction which is applied to moon, that we think that it may be evection term. There is its approximation
close to
the sun tantra sangraha values. So chapter 9, again dhada gunakara and again valyupasamhara, which is there are two methods. One is similar to the method given in Karana Paddhati, and there is an addition for that. Thanks to Professor M.D. Srinivas, has pointed out that it is a semi-irregular continued fraction, where when the hara becomes, the remainder becomes half of the divisor, then one has to subtract the, so if I explain it, it will take time. So it's a semi-regular continued fraction and normal continued fraction. So both are explained.
Negative
terms will come. So in the normal continued fraction, it will be alternate positive and negative.
Less than number of quotients.
And the chapter 10 is about spherical nature of the earth, circumference of the earth, and finally from 23rd verse to 37 in Sankranti Vakyas, obtaining true longitudes of the moon using Vakyas, mention of Yogyadi correction to obtain the true sun. And concluding remark, so Dhrikarana is a Karana text which is quite different from usual ones. Though we have understood most of the topics, some are unclear, so maybe we need to re-look into those things. We have to come to a conclusion about the authorship, careful analysis to know the relation with the text such as Karanottama and Sputanirnaya Tantra, because the Karanottama, the algorithm for finding Mandajyas and the epicycle diameters are similar to Karanottama, which is mentioned in the Karana. But the again planetary model Karanottama clearly defines the revised planetary model of Nilakantha. So whether that algorithm for whether it is peculiar to all Kerala Karana texts or only Karanottama or Sputanam, we have to see. And again, to come up. Date of Karanottama.
Uparaga Vinshati is 1594 or something. Karanottama is.
I am not sure about the date of. Yeah, I am not sure about.
That's
Yeah. Okay, thank you. Karana. It is not a pure Karana text. Yeah.
So anything beyond Saturn, It is not a naked eye observable. Yes, please.
Now, I thought this is asking.
Not me, not the speaker.
One second, please. One.
No, she was saying, so is there a methodology by which they revise the parameter? What are the observations which help us in revising?
Okay, the observation, especially during the eclipses, that is the, if your computational results. So for eclipses, we need to find the longitudes of longitude of the moon, the sun, and the node or Rahu. And there are certain algorithms to compute the duration of the eclipse and the instant of the eclipse which happens. So if the computational results match according with the observations, then we can say that the algorithm or the parameters are right. If it is not, so if there is a discrepancy, then finding that error, finding that discrepancy, one has to modify the parameters. So some Karana Paddhati gives a fifth, okay, how it's mathematical, it's, yeah. So. It says. The fifth chapter of Karana Paddhati deals with that. And again, today, Professor M.D. Srinivas was talking about one of the work where, I don't remember the work, where these revision, Jyotirmimamsa, where, these are dealt with.
But only general kind of discussion it is.
Yeah.
How exactly do you revise? I mean, I think they use the same framework and change the numbers. And maybe they were doing it, kind of a trial and error kind of thing. It's not very clear. How exactly they lead?
Not just eclipses, but also
other conjunction of planets, Vidipata, although, other aspects. One of the. Because eclipses you need latitude.
So, periodically you have to see in your calculation, saying if they are not right, you go on trying where you want to change. Whether you want to change parameters or the calculational procedures or even the theory. And over time, different theories come through, different calculational procedures come through. So, different schools of astronomy come. So, they also will sort of vie with each other saying we are better in calculating. So, it's a very complex thing.
Just one second. Professor Inga.
I have a question. Nothing to do with astronomy. One of the slides discussing, I think, the family of Jyesthadeva also showed that he was coming to the Nambuli Brahmin also. That's what I saw.
Is there an etymology for that word, Namburi or Nambudri, in a Sanskrit etymology? Because the in recent years a confusion has increased because there is a Babylonian derivation is given for that word, Nambubri. The persons who are
is not at all a Sanskrit word, sir.
No.
Also a name Embrantiri. Embrantiri is supposed to refer to the Brahmins who come from the north of Kerala. And Madhava is said to be a Embrantiri and not a Nambudri. And there are these Alga Kayas. From Tamil Nadu. You are also not Nambudris. But your ancestor is to be born with social historians of Kerala.
Our Nambu honesty. So that honesty and everything is implied. That term Nambu revealing.
So one who is
step. And Giri is just like what was
what is just
left. Nambu Giri comes in that way. If we want to explain it, nobody has explained it in that way, just I am giving the great meaning. And then Nambuli is the shortening of that Nambu Giri. And similar is the case for Embrantiri also. Embran means big, higher, respectable, like that. So that's also a higher cadre. The Mudri is and Embrantiri is And they are Tulu Brahmins as far as Embradris are concerned. From Tulu now.
South Kerala.
Tini is respectable, that's already I told. Unitiri. We have some caste also, say Unitiri. So many Tinis are there as well.
We can be reasonably sure that there is no Babylonian connect.
Writer name, the recent book by Professor Divakaran refers to some strange history of Kerala by some gentleman, which is available only in Malayalam, of course. And it says that, Professor Divakaran's book, as far as I have read. No, he is not. I don't know. What it says, this is just on the lighter side. So he says that this book in Malayalam by this scholar said that in 13th century, Nambudris formed nearly 30% of the population. And this peculiar marriage and succession policy amongst the Nambudris is what made this entire sort of community reduce in population, that it was only 3% in when the first censuses were carried out in 1870s and 1880s. So anyway, this is on the lighter side.
You heard us, yeah. No. It is only based on phenomenon. In fact, if you look at one of the earliest works, Aryabhatiya, he says, Ravindu Yogat Prasadhitas Chandraha. Shashi Ravi Yogat Dinakrat Ravindu Yogat Prasadhitas Chandraha. So this is how he says. So phenomenon of eclipse and conjunction of moon with stars also. So these are the various conjunctions that they look for and then try to see how they can correct it. As Professor Shriram was mentioning, it will be more by trial and error method.
So in order to distinguish both, he told the Kollam which is nearer to Trivandrum, that is south southern column and northern column. He has divided into that.
So we thank Dr. Pai. And incidentally, Dr. Pai, so one young historian award, which is presented by Indian National Science Academy. Indian National Science Academy. So this is a couple of years back. So, and his recent book.